driving here. I'm talking for a bit of a demonstration, so we take the fork slide grinder we have, and we show a bit of cutting, some grinding, form things in place, and clean up with the brush, a little bit of sanding, and then final polish, and see where we end up. Let's see if we get this cut. Oh dear, I think I made a mistake. I think I cut this off in the wrong place. Now we've got to weld it back. So I've got to make a B joint on this end so that we can weld it again. So we usually use the grinding stone for. So let's. On the inside. Well, here you can see that it removes quite a lot of material quite a short time. And, do the V joints and straighten this up. And that's what you usually use the grinding stone for. Just getting the brush prepared, and I usually leave the first spacer in place. Have to get a wrench. As you see, you can't use the normal tightening tool. You need to actually get a spanner shaft. And a spanner for that. And then that's where you need these protective glosses, where you have the protection from underneath. It's actually most necessary when you're using the brush. So now, let's see what the brush can do with this. And this rusty piece. Thank you. usually the level of cleanliness you can get. So you can get the rust off most of it and you get the paint to disappear. So, little trick, you need to get these in because they're thicker, then you need to put the guard in the center place, center position. And then move it back to wherever you want to have. The next level of cleanliness you can get with something this. One last first try. Okay, let's have a little bit of bench time. Because as we noticed when we tried to put this one in, it was possible to sort of get that in if we put that in some kind of a center position and then one could force it in. But of course this one won't put in there. Now, we have a little look at the instructions. Yeah. And then there is an open version of this one, so presumably, as you see, this is made of two parts, so we'll just take the external part off and then we'll move with this here. Problem is that I don't. From my region, there's no access to a Lidl or a Parkside online store, so we'll get that. So the only option remains to remove this guard, and theoretically speaking, you can do that by taking out a ring that goes around in there. So I have to try and do that. So, let's see how it goes. Something like that. Yeah, I can see the ring. Don't know if you can see it in camera. So, we're going to try and get that out. That came out easy. Surprise, surprise. So then, it needs to be in the center position to come off. Okay, now we got that off. So now we actually can fit this one. Thank you.
done. Well, that was easier than I thought. But I mean, actually, I should probably run this also with this cover removed. I think it would. I don't know. Actually, with that angle, you could probably get away with actually using it in here, like we were doing. It might actually. It will use the sandpaper flat-wise. But, yeah, so it's a bit of a choice thing to do. Or then, if those that have the access to the Lido Parkside online store, then they can just buy. Yeah, you can buy this protection cover, which is just this internal part and not both.
So, as you may or may not see, it's raining. The weather is trying to convince me not to make this demonstration. Well, I think I'll try and do it anyway. If I have a cloth, it's all getting soaking wet. I'll find something to wipe. This is very rough steel and it's been beaten up over time. Also, it's a bit rust. But that's it. I mean, this is how clean it got up in the end. But that's actually quite a good job of it. So. And of course, now this is going to get another layer of flash rust on. And we will come back to solving that problem in a later video. So, please consider subscribing. If you haven't already done so, hit the bell icon, hit the notifications, and yeah, we'll see you in the next one. That was what I was thinking of doing, except the weather, of course, didn't cooperate 100%, but we did it anyway.